Hi everyone, my name is Federico Tartarini, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can add to-do notes to your document in LaTeX. I'm going to show you a couple of examples, so you can choose the method that you like the most. I'm going to show you how to add notes with the to-do notes package, which I've seen that a lot of people like to use it, and you can add notes in line, as you can see here on the document, and on the side margin of your page. Then I will show you how to add notes here in line with the text, but they appear in a different color, like this one here. So I'm going to explain how to create a new command so you can change the color of the text. I will show you how to add notes here on the side without having to use the to-do notes package, but just using the command margin par here. I will go explain in detail about that as well. And I will show you my preferred way of adding notes is by adding a comment in line into your LaTeX document. Unfortunately, this is not going to work if you're only using Overleaf, but this last way I think is fantastic if you're using PyCharm, for instance, for compiling your document. If you want to find out more about how to use PyCharm to compile LaTeX document, I have a video already uploaded, so you can just look here at the top in the card and click on the card and find out more how to do that. The last method, adding a note with to-do, is going to work also if you're using Visual Studio Code or if you're using Vim. So let's start with this example and I will show you how to add these notes and how to add also a like note section at the end in which we have all the list of the to-do. So in order to get started with the to-do note package, which is the one that I'm going to cover first, you need to, of course, import the to-do note package, as you can see, as I'm doing here at the top. So let me zoom in a little bit more, so probably you can see a little bit better. Don't worry about the code. I'm going to copy the code down in the video description. So don't worry, just follow along with me, and then you can always copy the code later in the video description. I've got all these ideas from this post in Stack Exchange. However, it's lacking of explaining how to use the inline comment. So that's why I created this video, because I think that is also going to be very useful. But let me start with the to-do notes package. So we have to import the use package. With use package command, we have to import the... So we have to use use package to import the to-do notes command. And then we can add some options inside here. So we are going to add the coloring list of to-dos. We are going to say prepend caption, and we want the text size, which is tiny. Of course, we can change this. So let me actually change, and for instance, let me change from text size tiny, and I just use the default. So I can comment out this line, I can remove this, and I will show you how this is going to change in your document. I'm recompiling, pressing Ctrl Enter, and as you can see, if you don't use that option, use text tiny, then eventually we can read much better the notes. However, it has a downside that the note is going to look much bigger. If you're using Overleaf, another alternative that I'm not going to show here is to add comment with Overleaf, with the review panel here. So of course, you can always add comments here in this way, like adding like comment like this and say, let's say, change this, but this will not appear into your document. So I'm not going to cover it in detail in this video, because this has the downside that is always sync inside Overleaf. But if you get your document out from Overleaf and you push it to GitHub, and again, if you want to find out more, I have a video on that, how to sync Git, GitHub and Overleaf, this comment will not be synced. So let's go back to the video. So I hope now the scope of the video is clear. So let me go back, and we've seen how to change the option in the to-do notes package. But let's go back with the original, as I was showing you before. So we set back the text size to tiny, and then we are going to define some commands. We don't have to define this command. This is just something that you might find useful, and you might not need all this type of command. But the author of that post suggest you how to create a different type of cards. Why you would want a different type of cards? Because based on the type of comment, you can just change the color of the comment itself. So it's going to be easier for you when you review the document. Let's have a look at one of these new commands. So what we are doing here. So we can define with a new command, and then we have to put curly braces. Here we can define the type of command that we want to define. For instance, we want to say that this to do command is unsure, or we want to define in this blue the text that needs to be changed. Okay, so here we are defining the type of command that we want to give. These are the type of inputs, and then this is what are the arguments that are passed. So for instance, for the change option, so to change this type of text, when we want to leave a comment, we are going to say change curly braces, and then this is how it's going to be rendered. So it's going to be rendered in blue, the background is also going to be blue, and the border color is going to be blue. And then inside these to-do notes, we are going to specify what is the message. So for instance, if you go back here, we have a Latin text with this package lipsum. It's just a placeholder text. As you can see, this is the placeholder text. And then after this placeholder text, we can actually have this new command that we have defined, change, and here we are saying change this text. Okay? Of course, this can also be in within some text. So I can, of course, put this change this, let's say after my name, let's say that I've misspelled my name, I could have put it here. So I can recompile the document. And as you can see here, my name is Federico. And we can see that this line of the to-do note actually starts after Federico. So it starts after the text where we introduce the note. So here we have change. Of course, I've shown you how to add change, but with the same methodology, you can add a note for info, you can add a note for change, you can add a note for unsure, improvement, or you could even create a custom one. So right now, these are the examples that were provided, but of course, we can change this and we can create a new command here, which we can call it my new to do. You can change the color with this type of code here, and then you can create your new command. So if you want to have a particular to-do notes that you want to add. One other positive thing of the to-do note package is this, is that we can add the disable function here at the top. Why is it positive? Because let's say that now we are ready for publication. We have addressed the majority of the comments, and some of them we do not want to address them. So now it's going to be a bit of a pain because we have to go through each to-do here, and we have to comment it out or cancel it. But this could be a bit annoying. So the to-do notes come handy, package comes handy. We can add as an option disable. So let me show you that. So if I add here at the top disable, then I recompile the document, all the to-do notes that I've added with the to-do notes package are going to be disappearing. Of course, there is still this note here, and there is another note here, but because we haven't added with the to-do notes package. Finally, the last thing that I want to show you about the to-do notes package is how to add an inline comment. So we can see that we can add two inline comments. So to do an inline comment is pretty simple. Instead of just specifying the to-do, okay, followed by curly braces, we just have to specify here inside square bracket inline. So let me show you if I use the to-do without saying inline. So let me go back here. Instead of change, I'm going to use to-do. So I'm going to show you that this is going to result in a to-do command, which is on the side with the default color, which is orange. Now let me change this to inline. And then with square braces, I compile it again. This comment now is going to look inline. So this is going to break my sentence because this comment is inline. Inline comments are quite handy if you have a very long and wordy comment or to-do, because this is not going to have like a lot of text here on the margin, but we can have a lot of text here in line with the text. So let me revert back here. Of course, you can add inline, but you can also change the look and appearance of this inline comment by passing options. For example, here, we are passing also the color green. Of course, this could be color red. Let me change that, and I'm going to show you that this is changing from green to red. Finally, the last thing which is very nice from the to-do notes package is that we can add at the end of our paper, or basically we can add it wherever we want. It's just we can use this comment here to add a list of notes and a list of comments that we have added to the paper. And these are all color-coded. So that's why it was nice to color-code them at the beginning, to have different type of to-do notes, because these are going to be color-coded, and we know that the blue are changed this. So we need to definitely change this, but the things that are in red are unsure. So maybe we don't have to address this comment. So that's why it becomes handy. And of course, I can enable or disable this by just saying list of to-do notes and then put it in the square braces notes. If I, of course, comment it out, this is going to disappear. And let me comment it in, but change the argument here inside the square braces, notes to address. This is going to change the title of this section here at the top. So I hope everything was clear about the to-do notes. So let me disable them, because I want to show you the other type of notes that you can add to your document. And I want to show you the type of other option that you have if you want to comment your document. So another option that we have that is quite handy is to define a new command. So without importing the to-do notes package at all, we can just define a new command as we did before. And in this case, we define a new command. We call it my worries, or let's say we can call it even my notes. And then we specify the color of the text. So the color of the text is going to be in red. So now that I've changed this, I'm going to change it here in the text. So after this Latin text here, let me see where it is in the text. So it's going to be exactly this text here. We want to write a comment. So we can say my notes, and we say not sure about this. So let me recompile the document. This also is a very handy way of adding notes to your document. Why? Because first of all, it's in line with the text and in a different color, so we know that it's a note. It's not going to take extra space, so it can be as long as you want. So if you have it here on the side, as you can see, the to-do notes were becoming very long if they were very wordy. But in this case, it's going to be in line with text, so it's not going to be a problem at all, despite the length of the note. And it's also very handy because we can renew the command here at the beginning and say my worries one. So one is the input of the argument of the comment, and we can say curly braces. This is going to be very nice because we, again, as we did with the to-do notes, if you don't want to display the to-do notes because we want to submit our document, we don't have to cancel them one by one, but we can add this command here. We can recompile the document, and the note is going to disappear in the final document. Of course, now we change the command. So from my worries, I will call it my notes. So that's why we got an error. So I recompile the document now, and the notes are gone. And you could have had many in the document. So now I added only one, but let me add the two of these. So I recompile. Of course, nothing is appearing right now because we have this renew command, my notes. But if I enable it again, then I'm going to have two notes. Another option, which comes by default with LaTeX, so you don't have to add any new command or you don't have to import any package, is margin bar. So we can write something in the margin. So it's very similar to the to-do note command, but then we have less customization. So with margin bar, we can just write a note here in the margin, but at the same time, we don't have much control. So when we want to get rid of this note, we'll have to comment it out with a percentage sign in front of it. So let me add a percentage sign in front of it, and then let me disable also the my notes. So I recompile the document. Now our document is clean. So it's ready for submission. So these are the main way that they were listed on this post on Text Exchange. But now I will want to show you my preferred way of handling comments. And I have two reasons why this, in my opinion, is the best way. So let me add a comment with to-do comment. So let me show you how I do normally. After this text, so let's say my name is Federico and I'm a postdoc at the university to make videos on YouTube. I add a comment in this way. I say percentage sign, and then I say to do, and say, I will say my name, so F, because that is me, or I can say my name by my surname, so FT, and then I'm going to say, change this text. And then I compile the document. Of course, we will not be able to see anything in the document, but that is a very good behavior because this is a note, so we don't want that the note is shown into the document, okay? So that is very important. But these, which are the advantages of this? First of all, it's much simpler to write, because when you have to write a to-do note, at least in my opinion, it's much longer to write that, because you have to say change, And then you have to have the curly braces, and then you say change this, but then you have to go outside from the curly braces. In this way, it's much easier because you add just a percentage sign, or you can press Ctrl forward slash, and then you write the to-do note, my name, and then you write whatever you want, and then you press Enter, so you're already outside. So I think it's, first of all, much easier to write. And the second thing that I like this method is because it doesn't appear in the text. And the reason why I really like it is because I write my document not using Overleaf, but using Textify in PyCharm. So let me open Textify in PyCharm. So here I have an example of a document, okay? And this is the document that I have. So when I had a to-do in line, let me actually increase the font size so you can see better. So we can say 16 here. So now you can see this is my section, which is introduction. Again, I just have some placeholder text. Don't worry too much about it. But the big advantage of using to-do in line is that I can say, I can put a command, again, with Ctrl forward slash. I can say to-do, and then I can say FT, and then I can say change this text. So why is it so beneficial? Because regardless of where I put my to-do notes in my document, my PyCharm is going to find all the to-do notes. So inside here, as you can see, I have an introduction, I've added a note. So I have another video on how to show how to structure a research paper if you want to use the Elsevier template. But basically I have the main text file in which I import all the different sections, okay? So introduction, methodology, results, and blah, blah, blah. So then I have the different section of the paper. So if I add a to-do note, as I'm doing here, PyCharm automatically, it finds out where the to-do note is. And I can add one here in the introduction, but I can also add something in the methodology. So let me go into the methodology. Here I want to add a to-do note. At the end of this sentence, I can add another one here. And what is the big advantage? First of all, the big advantage is that, as I showed before, these to-do notes are not going to appear in the text, so I'm always ready to submit the document. I don't have to just take them away. And the second and big advantage, at least in my opinion, is that I can quickly toggle through these to-do notes, and PyCharm is going to find them all in the text for me. And this is not entirely true for the to-do notes package. Or maybe, yes, you have a list of to-do notes at the end, which you can also use hyperref to link them and to click on them and navigate to where they are. But it takes much more time. Every time you have to go to the bottom of the document, click on the note, and then you're going to be redirected where the note is. Here is much easier, because if you use any IDE, you can configure that when you write the word to do, it's going to be highlighted, and then eventually you can navigate through all the to do in the text. So at least in my opinion, this is the best way of handling to-do notes. I really hope you find this video interesting. If you have any question, please let me know, or if I wasn't clear, just write a comment down in the section below. If you found the video interesting, please consider liking the video and subscribing to my channel. It really helps me a lot because I'm new here on YouTube, and it really helps with the YouTube algorithm, so my video are going to be shown to more people. If you also want to support my work and my channel, please consider buying me a coffee. You can do so by going on the website Buy Me a Coffee, and you can find a link in the video description below. But if you don't want to do that, don't worry. Just please consider liking my video. Thank you for listening, and see you next time.